Hello everyone, welcome to this session. In this unit, we are going to study regarding the various service reservoirs, design of the service reservoirs, not only that, also the associated distribution network, then design of this distribution network, then in the pipeline, the various walls which are provided between this pipeline, which are controlling the flow or adjusting the flow rate. So all these walls we are going to study. So starting with the service reservoirs. So as you know, the after filtration of the water, disinfection treatment is given to the water, and this water is now ready to serve to the consumers, and this water is stored in a reservoir which is called as a service reservoirs. Now there are various types of service reservoirs are there based on the design of that particular water supply or water treatment plant. Now how this particular reservoirs are working and what are their various types, so we are going to study regarding this in today's session. Now service reservoirs, it is also known as a distribution reservoirs. These are the storage reservoirs which store the treated water for supplying the water. Now types of the distribution reservoirs are surface reservoir, elevated reservoir and stand reservoir, or simply the last one, the stand reservoir, it called as a stand pipe. Now in the this sequence of the water treatment plant or water treatment process, the last part which comes where are the service reservoirs, and from the service reservoirs the distribution network that works, and that depends again upon the how the city is there and how the distribution network is planned. Now we will have the glance on this today, the service surface reservoir, elevated service reservoir. It is also called as the elevated service reservoir or ESR, and stand reservoir or stand pipes. Now actually, what is the function of this distribution reservoirs or service reservoirs? First one is to equalize the variation in hourly demand of water by the consumers to uniform rate of supply from the source, either by gravity or pumping. Now again, after storing the water, this water is supplied to the consumer on the different demand, you can say. So that we have also gone through, that in the morning the demand is more, in the afternoon the demand is different, at night some hours the demand is again increases. So likewise, to compensate all these variations in the water demand, so water distribution reservoir helps because of the storage of that water. Not only that, also here, so when the water is stored in the reservoir, so how it is to be distributed to the consumers, by the pumping method or by gravity method or by dual method, combined method, that is also decided on by the distribution reservoir. Then next one is maintain the desired minimum residual pressure in the distribution system to provide the required time for the disinfectant added in the order to achieve effective disinfection. So it also allows some time there to disinfect the water. Not only that, again because of the water head, so the pressure at the different levels in the distribution system, that will be as per the desired, to facilitate carrying out repairs either to pumping or to pump set without interruption to the supply of water. So if you are having the ample storage of water and which is to be supplied to the consumer, so in between if there any repair occurs or repair is to be done of any pump set or any other appliances or appurtenances, so you can carry out all that. Now, what are the components and functions of the water distribution reservoir? So, first one is the inlet pipe for the entry of water, outlet pipe connected to the distribution mains for the exit of water, overflow pipe discharging into drain gutters and maintaining the constant level, a float gauge or an indicator for indicating the depth of water which can be read out from outside, a washout pipe for removing the water after cleaning the reservoir, automatic devices to stop pumping when the tank is full. So all these things are there. Very obvious that first one is the inlet pipe is there, which brings the water to the reservoir. Then outlet pipe is connected, which provides the water to the distribution network. Overflow pipe discharging in case of any overflow. So the water that should not come out from the top portion, instead of that it is discharged to the drain gutters. A float gauge or indicated. So it is associated, a pipe is provided which gives the water level, which shows the water level present in the tank or that particular reservoir. Then a washout pipe for removing the water after cleaning the reservoir. So this is a part of the maintenance. So when the after a typical period, the water that reservoir is washed, and so whatever the this water washout water, so it is removed from this particular washout pipe. Automatic devices to stop pumping when the tank is full. Sometime we can provide a different float gauges or which are synchronized with the electronic system, so that when the water is full, so automatically the pump stops. So these are the various components of a reservoir. Now again, further, the ladders are also provided to reach the top of the reservoir. Because the height is more, and we'll have to, if you want to reach there, the ladder is necessary. Then up to the bottom of the reservoir from the inspection. Not only that, so it is provided from the to reach the top of the that particular reservoir, and again in the reservoir itself, the ladder is necessary to reach the bottom as well. Manholes for providing entry into the tank for the inspection purposes. Okay, so from the top side, the holes are provided there, and ventilator for the fresh air circulation. Okay, so some holes are provided there. Okay, so here you can see the how the inlet pipe is there, right? The how the vents are provided. Okay, so how the water is passed there. So that depends upon the design of that particular reservoir. Now let's have the various types of glance on the various types of reservoirs. First one is the surface reservoir, which is actually constructed on the ground. So surface reservoirs are circular or rectangular tanks constructed on the ground level or below the ground level, you can say. Therefore they also called as a ground reservoirs. They are generally constructed at high points of the city and in a gravitational type of distribution system and pumping system are used to for the treated water to fill the reservoir. Now if you see this particular, if you are constructing this particular reservoir on ground, definitely the area which you are serving, that should be at the lower altitude than this, so that the water can be supplied to this particular distribution area by the gravity. So it is generally provided at the higher altitude on the ground, so that water can be safely provided to the consumers. Next one is the elevated service reservoir, elevated reservoirs. You can see here, these are elevated up to top portion. Here you can see, so you can find out it is mounted on the various columns, right? And this is the water reservoir present there. You can see the here the grills are provided. So this is the ladder which is provided to approach the top side, and also inside that also the ladders are present, right? So you can see here at bottom, you can visualize two pipes are there. This is one and another is pipe is there. So one is the inlet pipe for that and another is the outlet pipe. Okay, so not only that, so along with this here, so somewhere the this where you can take the water level also, a pipe, a transparent pipe is also provided to see the water level in the tank. So let's have the glance on this elevated service reservoirs or elevated reservoirs. These are elliptical overhead tanks erected at certain suitable elevation above the ground level and supported on towers. They are constructed in the areas combined gravity and pumping system for the water distribution is adopted. Water pumped into these elevated tanks from the filter units or from the service reservoirs and then supplied to the consumers. These tanks may be made of RCC steel or pre-stressed concrete. Okay, so it is a dual combination. The water is pumped into this tank or reservoir, stored there, and then again supplied to the consumers. Okay, one more method is there, which is called as the stand pipes or stand reservoirs. Now these are the stand pipes are kinds of elevated tank without any erected towers or the for resting the body. Directly these are present on the water pipeline itself. There are the tall cylindrical shell resting directly on the ground. So generally most of the first two methods are used, but stand pipes are used in a very typical situations. Now, storage capacity of a reservoir. The total storage capacity of a distribution reservoir is the summation of the balancing storage, which is equalizing or the operating storage as well, breakdown storage and fire storage. So we'll have to consider all these three. What is balancing storage? The main and primary function of the distribution reservoir is to meet the fluctuating demand with a constant rate of supply from the treatment plant. The quantity of water required to be stored in the reservoir for equalizing or balancing this variable demand against the constant supply. So as we have discussed earlier, here we have to take the care of the maintenance of the pump. So in the breakdown period also, if surplus water is necessary, treated water, that should be also accommodated in the reservoir capacity. So all these things are considered, and so that the a constant water can be supplied to the consumers. What is breakdown storage? It is also called as the emergency storage. It is the storage prevented in order to tide over the emergencies posted by the failure of pumps, electricity, or any other mechanism driving the pump. So here as we have discussed that in case of maintenance, the water if it remains for some period, so that per particular period the water must be available in the reservoir. Fire storage, the third component of the total reservoir storage. In case of fires, sufficient amount of water must remain available in the reservoir for throwing it over the fire. Remember here, so always this emergency water that is always present in the water reservoir to take care of the fire storage. So today we have discussed regarding the types of various storage reservoirs, various functions of the reservoirs, components of the reservoirs, and necessary, or you can say what important or care should be taken in the design of the reservoir. So thank you very much for joining these sessions. In coming session again we are discussing regarding the how the water is supplied to the cities and what are the various necessary components associated with the distribution of the water.